The authorities in Chikube district are concerned about the increasing cases of mob justice across the district. It's understood one person is suspected of committing a crime, promptly accused by residents who surround him and clobber him to death. The RDC for Chikube district, Amran Tumusime, says most of the victims who've been identified are often accused of witchcraft.
According to authorities in Chikube district, in less than 1 week, the district has registered 4 cases of mob justice.
Mob justice is very unfortunate that it's the alarming rate at which it's increasing lately is very worrying, of course. And as the authorities, we are trying as much as possible to sensitize our people on ground. First and foremost, there's a lot of lost hope. People have lost hope in the security system that is trying to do its best to bring about sanity in the area. But as you well are aware, that the security itself is overstretched.
We want to condemn mob justice, which is becoming very rampant in Chikube district. You can imagine in a period of a week, losing 4 people due to mob justice. And partly mob justice coming as a result of witchcraft. For example, about 5 days ago, an old man in his late 80s called Kule Daudi was killed by a mob together with a visitor.
Some of the victims include Daudi Kule, an 82-year-old man and resident of Changwali sub-county. He was attacked and killed after he was accused of hiding his son, who allegedly practices witchcraft. The residents also killed a visitor who had gone to check on the old man. Peter Banura, the Chikube District LC5 chairperson, has decried mob justice. He says action must be taken to address this disturbing trend.
Effort that is needed for everybody. It's not only one entity's responsibility, but it is a collective effort that appeals to everybody in their responsible dockets to come up and do their part. Mob justice is not something, it's not a piece of cake, it's not something to smile about. It is a loss of dear life. And if we leave it at that and it goes on, it spirals into dangerous situations that endanger the security of the country, endanger the security of the district and the areas where we are trying to have sanity in this area.
The resident district commissioner, Amran Tumusime, noted that sometimes the people killed are innocent of the crime they are being accused of. He encouraged the public to call the police whenever they suspect that someone in their community has committed a crime, instead of taking the law into their own hands.
People have killed, you know, suspects, and you very well know in our laws, one is always innocent until proven guilty. So at times some innocent people have lost their dear lives out of that kind of negligence and ignorance of the law. So it's a big challenge as a district, but we are doing all that is possible to try to lobby at the center to be able to get more support in terms of mobilization, to sensitize our people, to bring about some bit of, you know, collective responsibility, both at the district level, at the sub-county.
Tumusime has warned that whoever takes part in mob justice will be apprehended and taken to court to answer for murder.
You are making a very big mistake, and definitely we shall arrest all of you. We are very much looking for these people. I'm told the chairman LC1, Nichangwali, after mobilizing people and killing these 2 people, took off. But good enough, we have identified all of them and we are looking for them. And very soon, definitely, we shall get them. And once we get them, we shall charge them.
Report by Ismail Kasoha for the news in Chikube District.